and then you slow it down a bit, add your mechanical decision making all throughout, I think OHIP can do this. If it is, it's going to be an OHIP.
But again, this is what I was saying before we go into draft. The differences between both these teams is from the side of Blacklist, they want to out-sustain you. From the side of RQ, they want to deal as much damage as possible. So right now we do have to see which is the superior style of team fighting.
Let's see as we are entering the portal to enter the Land of Dawn. Are you guys ready? RRQ and Blacklist International, the Royal Rumble starts now.
All I'm thinking is in Haji, just keeping up this presence here in the Riverside. And it is confirmed, going to be the Esmeralda on OHIP going up against Skylar's Cho. It's this kind of matchup when it really is a 50-50. Decision making is going to be key. And already Haji, wow, forced out the recall.
Yeah, and like I said, it's actually Cho in the gold lane for Skylar. So like I said, Vin already doing so well here in the early stages, getting the stun. And oh, Venus caught very low. Skylar is rotated.
Oh!
The Prince of the Skies have come to play. First blood by Razor.
Could have sworn Skylar flew there, man. He's so fly. OHIP did not notice. Hey, wait, where's the Cho? Oh, there he is. First blood on the Queen. Interestingly enough, it's a matter of Blacklist International keeping them their composure. How will they recover from this early first blood? No one expected that.
And the thing is, I like what Skylar is already doing. It's like, yeah, they subbed me in. I'm going to show why I should be on the stage right now. RRQ Hoshi, they're dictating this pace. Can they keep this up? Wise right now, he's being pressured in his own jungle.
We got to talk about how they're dictating the pace. They are winning their lanes. This is the main win condition for them. Winning lanes and transitioning it to plays on the board. But for the side of Blacklist, they don't want to give this pressure easily. Haji already punishing that mid lane by pushing it through. Venus as well, as Vin goes for the stun, just trying to stop their rotation so far as R7 just will pop that recall.
Yep, here you see now RQ Hoshi crossing down into the lower quarter. Small camp going to be taken. Vin, 2v1 here. Might be a little too much. Shield is up.
Oh, very aggressive, forcing the flicker, but Edward, he wants more. He's going to jump in, and that's going to be Vin running away. Edward still unable to get it, but Wise with the Mountain Shocker answers with the Equalizer. RRQ now in a bad position as Blacklist just keeps on going for this turtle. Let's see what happens. R7 jumps in with a Fierce Dive, able to connect onto Wise, but that is going to be the dash coming in. RRQ still very aggressive, but Blacklist have rotated 4 members. Very good cancel by the King of Kings.
That's going to be a hard reset on the turtle. Blacklist International, they made the call, but right now, going to go for the Feathered Airstrike. They're still playing footsies with the turtle. As I was saying, Blacklist International, they understood the dynamic here. And yeah, they know that R7 is going to be here, going to be able to draw that lion as the Yuzhong. Black Dragon form helping confirm this turtle for Albert, who actually really needs a turtle. Albert needs to get his farm up.
Yeah, and the thing is, what's so good about that turtle take was that RQ Hoshi, they understand that they cannot take a fight on the turtle side because it will be won by the side of Blacklist International because this Nathan being so close to the turtle makes it a very, very easy target. So the fact that they zone everyone out first, they understand that Wise is going for his purple is the correct time to actually initiate on this turtle. So they played a very good macro over there, giving a lot of space for Albert to keep on farming. And right now, looking at the farm, 1,808 gold for Albert, going up against Wise, Yi Sun-Shin, 1,819. So far, it's been very equal for both sides.
Yep, tiny, tiny margin here for RRQ Hoshi. I guess that's what the early first blood on Oh My Venus Matilda bought them. But so far, Blacklist International, this is what they're good at. They understand when they're ahead. They understand when they need to catch up. So RRQ Hoshi, I'm not sure if they're equipped. Honestly, we need to see Skylar more leaving OHIP, finding kills elsewhere so that they can bear down on Blacklist. But so far, Blacklist has a different plan. Look at how much they're giving here up top. I do believe there is some shield left. Yes, a minute left on this timer before they can run it out.
You know, it's very interesting to see that gold lane, right? Because it is the battle of the princes here of Mobile Legends. And now, right as of right now, it's still RRQ with the gold lead. Very, very small, but this is exactly what they want in the early stage. Vin already going in. This is what they want, but wait a minute. Vin goes in aggressively using that Numinous Blast.
I guess it's an effort to zone, and Haji answers back. Neither of them really know that they're going to be committing. So now it's a question of when is the next big team fight, how it's going to happen, and who can convert faster. Right now, by the fact that OHIP is pinning down Skylar, I think this is better for Blacklist International because Skylar can actually help confirm more kills.
Yeah, right now we can see that Albert just finished that Hunter Strike. I feel like in terms of when they're going to fight, it's definitely going to be on Vin as well as Venus. Whenever they say go, then the entire team will go. From the side of my Venus, actually, if he plays around with like going in to the fight, being able to target Albert, then Blacklist International, they might just say go. And right now, the turtle has been started.
Oh, but right now, it's going to be really good for the side of Blacklist International. Finn gets chunked very, very low. It's going to be Blacklist picking up the turtle. RRQ looking for the fight, though. It's going to be Albert going in for the entropy, able to take it out. But, but look at R7. He's diving the backside. He's going in. Edward can't go anywhere. Skylar will be able to lock him down. But look at Edward. He's still able to fight. He's still able to run. Skylar is going to go under the turret, unable to get anywhere as Wise comes in and picks up the kill. On to Skylar. Blacklist have gone to 4-3.
Not only is he the Filipino sniper, he's also the Filipino dancer. Did you see how Oheb just went around that team fight? That's exactly what the Esmeralda wants.
Yeah, and again, looking at that previous team fight, this is why I say RRQ Hoshi, they should not be fighting at the turtle, because Blacklist International, they have a better draft controlling that area, because they have the far side, they have the superiority in terms of range as well as earlier damage. And Wise on this Yusen Shin, he wants to get close, he wants to get his stacks on the passive.
Yeah, but you can see the Numenon Blast being used, and Oheb is going to get picked up on the map. RRQ equalizes once more in the fifth minute, and this is what they need to do. Blacklist International, they want to group up. Ube is time. It's almost time, 7 minutes on the clock very, very soon. Oh, but look at this though. RRQ have rotated to the top side. Blacklist responds instantly, but Venus gets chunked to half HP. They won't try to look for a fight here, as RRQ will still be able to control the map a little bit more here in the 6 minute.
Yep, 5 minutes in, the shields go down. So that means the gold lane will get less damage reduction, hence the switch up here. So now Edward is actually pressuring R7 down bottom and gets that first turret of the game. It's going to open up the map. Now we talked about earlier how R7, the relentless one, is going to buy time. That's kind of sideways now. You kind of have to have plan B.
Oh, but wait a minute. Blacklist are trying to collapse here in that top side. R7 jumps in for the Furious Dive. Unable to connect onto anyone. It's going to be the Father Airstrike and the stun. Oh! R7, he has nowhere to go. Pops the Black Dragon form as the Numenon Blast will be baited away. Amazing guiding win. And Blacklist will be able to take another turret on the board. 2-1 right now.
Masterfully done. Blacklist International played that quarter of the map so well. They dodged the ult. They used their ults. And then they knew their priority. They could have forced out the kill on R7. But they did it. They knew that it was all about the turret, all about getting ahead of RRQ Hoshi. There's a turtle slain brought to you by the STB. Now they're ahead, almost 2K.
Yeah, and right now, Blacklist International, it is the 7 minute mark. For some reason, Blacklist International at 7 minutes, they go ham. Wise almost completing his Blade of Despair. Once he does, Blacklist International basically has a go button to say, we're gonna go anywhere.
Oh, look at that way, the dragon connecting on Edward, and that's gonna be another pick off for the side of RRQ, trying to equalize in the gold lead, but that's not what you need. You need to be able to translate these kills onto objectives, and Vin, he's already looking for something here. They have one person picked off on the board. It's time to look for more.
Mind you, Vin here has all his resources. The Numenon Blast, he has a Flicker, so he can find these odd angles, but it looks like Blacklist International not gonna let that happen. That's what you get with the Yusen Shin. You know exactly where everyone is, and for the most part, you know exactly how and where opponents are gonna set up death bushes, and that's where R7 should come in. So far, he's sitting at 1-0-1. Not too late. He can scale up as the Yuzhong.
Yeah, but right now, honestly, for the side of RRQ Hoshi, one of their better win conditions right now is Skylar. If Skylar can win a 1v1 against Edward or Oheb, then they unlock two different ways to win the game. Either go through team fights or split pushing, because if he can win that 1v1, they can go ahead and make Blacklist International follow their own pace, whether they go good or not.
Skylar just styling right there. An amazing pickoff. Didn't even use the flicker, mind you, as RRQ slowly but surely trying to equalize that gold lead. But Blacklist, they're grasping onto it.
Yeah, we talked about Skylar and how he actually is such a threat when it comes to team fights. And when he decides to go for a kill. Now, is that not a paradox? We're saying he should split push here. He should help open up the map. But if he's participating in these team fights to help RRQ catch up, it's not gonna happen. And just like that, Edward showing off as well.
Yeah, Clay over-aggressive there without the Purify and the Black Shoes. But look at this, Edward already going in onto Vin right now. Using the knockoff strike. Haji does not have the Feather Airstrike to follow it up. But Edward, he might be able to deal the damage himself as the Lord comes up. And Blacklist, they're onto it instantly. RRQ, will they try to look for this? It's going to be Edward jumping in once again. R7 zoned away. Feather Airstrike going to be able to zone Vin away. R7, he's looking for the opening. Skylar in the back front. Is going to the Lord take it away? But no, we have Blast! Will connect on a three. Edward comes in for the ball up. It's going to be all fun, all out fight. R7 on the backside. Haji's going to be able to take them down. Killing speed picked up by Wise. And RRQ are not going to be able to trade anything except for that mid lane tier one.
And right now, Blacklist International playing around the win conditions on the side of RRQ Hoshi. We were talking about Skylar on this show. He has two win conditions. Either join the team fights at Lord, making sure that he can take care of either Wise or Haji, or he can split push. In that situation, Skylar was aiming for Wise, but he being in between all of his teammates and actually using the traceless, timed it perfectly to make sure that he is not caught by this Cho, making sure Blacklist International, Arkyoshi, they didn't have a way to stop their damage.
Oh, they don't have a way to even stop this siege from happening. That's tier two for Blacklist as they're looking for more onto the purple buff. Albert is trying to contest it with the help of Vin. Let's see who gets it. It is going to be Wise with the Retribution, but it's going to be Skylar jumping into the backside, unable to do anything. He's going to get picked off, and Blacklist have struck again. It's going to be 1-0. Blacklist will be able to take this tier one as well, and they're controlling this game, the tempo.
What a counter death bush. Skylar could have sworn he got Wise there, but as Lovell mentioned, Skylar was looking for something. He may have gotten overloaded when it comes to decision making. So yeah, do I go for Wise? Do I go for Haji? Do I go for who? And right now, it's all about Blacklist making these decisions for RRQ Hoshi. That's what's happening here, and they're dictating the pace. RRQ Hoshi, they're like, oh, never mind. I guess we'll let him go. We have to protect ourselves.
Speaking of decision making, what is the decision coming in from the side of RRQ Hoshi? As of right now, looking at Albert, he already has the Hunter Strike as well as the Blade of Despair. The damage is okay, it's good. They want to kite, or do they want to engage? Right now, they're trying to engage.
Oh, Haji, catch four people onto that stun right now. As Ohib looking for the Falling Stun, unable to connect, but if the Airstrike will be able to bring Clay down. Vin is next on the chopping block. Wise dashes in, and that's going to be Ohib picking up the kill. A 2-4-0. Blacklist are trying to end the game right now in 11 minutes.
Textbook reversal. The rope-a-dope by Blacklist International was setting up a bush that was actually very, very lethal. There is a Purify. Haji didn't even use it. Haji just wings by wings out. That was prime instincts for them. And now R7 scrambling, trying to survive, protect this inhibitor turret.
What's Skylar doing? Skylar is actually able to clear the waves right there. That was a very, very good defense for the side of RRQ, buying them a little bit more time, but the Mountain Stalker will be able to connect. Edward jumping in. Skylar going for in for the way the dragon, but it is not going to help him. It's going to force the inevitable. Blacklist strikes blood one more time. 10-6 on the killing board.
There's a reason why they call him Edward Balboa. There's a reason, and that's why.
Yeah, and right now for the side of RRQ Hoshi, we have to look at a drop and see what are they really trying to do, because it's a mix-up. They kind of want to kite, they kind of want to engage, and I feel like this is actually harming them in terms of decision-making on defending this.
Oh, look at the range, the damage coming in. RRQ, what are they able to do? Edward goes over to the knockoff strike, not even respecting the side of RRQ. They're not responding. Edward just is styling on him, but Lumen Blast coming in. Edward with the help, but it's going to be the stun coming in. Edward's going to be picked up on the map. Achilles speed for Albert as they're looking for more on the board, but the inhibitor turret will be traded. That is very much worth it for the side of the Filipino champs. Only Edward dying for that trade.
Yep, and there is a silver lining for RRQ Hoshi here. They manage top lane very well, so they can threaten to push that. But yeah, it's Ohib back on the response. Haji, not at all gun-shy to use his Feathered Airstrike when it's necessary to clear waves.
Yeah, and this is the thing why I say getting Nathan very, very early on is very, very, I would say, very risky, because again, you're letting go of the Farsa. The Farsa is already very good at handling marksmiths just because she can outrange anyone. Doesn't matter who, she can outrange basically anyone. And again, Blacklist International, we were able to get Edward to use the Paquito, which also, again, is very good against these marksmiths. And this is just becoming a situation where Albert is having difficulties finding ways to deal out the damage.
It's going to be very hard, again, because of Haji and Edward, but they're looking for a pick once again. Venus actually goes in very aggressively, still able to run away now, but it's half HP gone. But look at Skylar. He's playing this really, really well, able to kite in the wave, but it's going to be Edward jumping in once again. Both teams just trying to poke each other out right now, trying to look for the setup, because right now it's actually Skylar with a very good flank.
Much like his moniker, the Prince of the Skies, he has to fly between this Lord and that bottom lane. He has to manage his time, has to make the right decision every time, because it could either be life or death. He could buy a turnaround for Arkihoshi, or they could lose this Luminous Lord and then Blacklist just do exactly what they've been doing for the past 5-6 minutes.
Yeah, I like what Skylar is doing here. He's trying to play the cross map, and they're trying their best to set up pressure there, because that is the wave with the inhibitor trying to take it down. R7 going in for Haji is going to be forcing him to use the Wings by Wings. Finn using the Numenon Blast, but Skylar almost gets picked off on by Wise. R7 is looking for an engage again, but RRQ, they have to disengage. Ohev going in for Falling Simon onto two members. Oh. It's going to be Venus coming in as well. Albert's going to be the target. Slaver kind of with the entropy, baiting four members in. But Edward, he's coming with a Dockhaw strike, able to get onto Clay, but it's going to be the Black Shoes pop. He's juking all around. He's going to get taken down, and Blacklist have found a 1-0 trade on the board.
At some point, I thought they were going to do the Hokey Pokey and shake it all about. Ooh. I don't know if you know that song. It's a very old song. But yeah, they turned that one kill into a quick Lord, easy, like they did at the 9-minute mark. Blacklist International, they're playing out of their minds here. Their time, it's off the charts. Arkihoshi, how do they answer back here?
Again, we have to look at Albert as well as Skylar. Skylar, like we predicted, this is how he wants to play the game. He's going to play the macro game, but in case situations where they are fighting against Lord, he wants to go to the backline and try to initiate a kill. But look at Albert, how he was targeted. Matilda targeted him, and then bringing Edward this Paquito, there's no way that he can kite. And then Haji opening that Feather S-Rike, he's not doing damage this game.
It's all about the peel for RRQ. If they're able to peel Albert or not, Skylar now already channeling in. That is going to be the Jeet Kune Do. Will he try to use it? Nope, only on the minions, but this is just buying a little bit more time. Blacklist, they want to push with that bottom side that is building up.
Yep, this kind of defense actually benefits Arkihoshi. Gotta give him that, because they have all the resources to make sure Albert gets the free hits. There's not much dive for Blacklist International. They really only have to watch for Edward. Ohev's a very honest type of hero here, dancing around the Esmeralda. They are gonna miss out on mid inhibitor. They're gonna lose top lane as well, but there's a fight now breaking out.
Yeah, look at the fight. It's an all-out brawl right now as R7 dives to the backside. It's gonna be the point. Time connects out of three! Oh my god, Ohev! But Albert will be able to burst one. A 1-for-1 right now as R7 is still soaking in the damage. Wise trying to get more done on the board, but look at Skylar. He's trying to proxy in that bottom side map. He's trying to buy some time for RRQ, but they need him in the base right now, right here. Vin goes in for the defense, still able to zone away the members, but it's going to be R7 taking a lot of damage. Vin chunks in, puts up his shield, and Blacklist are forced to back away.
Right now, looking at this game again, Blacklist International, they just take a straight road. They understand what is the best plays that they can do with the heroes that they have. And the way that they do it is very, very simple. Just keep your range strong. And then Ohev as well as Edward, they deal with the front lines and they don't mind, because as long as Wise as well as Haji just keep their distance, do this amount of damage, they're gonna win no matter what. 7,000 gold lead for the side of Blacklist International. The only way they lose right now, if they overcommit and Arkihoshi just translate a winning team fight into a straight run to the base.
Yep, there's this whole dynamic of Arkihoshi having all the tools to try and break the code right now, because yes, they have the Yuzhong, they have the Cho, and it's so clear where the damage is coming from. It's gotta be Albert.
Skylar needs to be careful right now. Blacklist are trying to collapse. Oh my Venus, he has the Circling Eagle. Feather Airstrike to zone him away, but that's gonna be the flicker used. 80 seconds onto the Lord. Blacklist tried to go for something, but RRQ still able to run away from that.
This is exactly what I was talking about. It's RRQ Hoshi with the tools, but it seems like Blacklist International is such a big problem right now that the formula just isn't there yet. They've been trying. It took 3 inhibitor turrets for them to figure out that, okay, maybe Skylar should stick a little closer to us. Maybe this whole lane cutting, proxying thing, it's gotta tone down a little bit, because we're not getting much. So, I think for Arkihoshi, next step should be making sure that Clay actually is part of the team fights.
The later the game goes, the harder it's going to be for them because of those 3 inhibitor turret takes. Blacklist will have constant pressure. Not just constant pressure, but build-ups all in all lanes. 3 of them. Look at that. It is the build-up coming in, that top side, mid lane, and the bottom side. They have stacked minions coming in. And with this 7,000 gold lead, even though we are in the 18th minute, RRQ will most probably will be able to catch up in terms of items. The pressure is just not there for them.
Yeah, right now I feel like Arkeoshi, they really have to respect Edward right now because he is providing a lot of trouble for them. Because again, every single time that Skylar wants to engage, wants to go in, same with Albert, he's going to be there peeling off the side of Blacklist International and Wise, as well as Haji. The way that they play, they really like sticking close to All My Venus because they know every single time Arkeoshi, they try to single target anyone out. As long as they're clumped up together, they're going to have a very difficult time to aim their targets properly.
Right now, it is going to be Blacklist with the full control.
I love how Haji actually knows that Vin is there. There could have been more, but now they answer back.
Ooh, Clay gets chunked to half HP. Still has regeneration. The lanes have been set up perfectly by RRQ, but Oheb, he's looking for a collapse. Falling Star Moon unable to connect. A big resource being used too, actually. But the cooldowns are on very short. It's very short cooldowns for both of the ultimates. Blacklist can just wait it out, wait for the other minions to come by and go for it again. They're not even gonna wait. It's gonna be RRQ forced to respond to this. This is a desperate move. This is a forced error that Blacklist are trying to do. Let's see if RRQ can fight this. Skylar, he is proxying the wave once again, but he might be caught here with Oheb returning. No, he is going to be able to back away. Vin, though, very aggressive. What is this? Concealed to back away. Falling Simon able to connect onto Vin right now. He's going to go for an all-out fight. Vin pops in the number one blast, but he's going to get taken down. Edward now in a 1v3, able to get three people onto the knockoff strike. But Skylar, he's looking for a flag. Oh. He's not going to be able to get anyone. Why is he going to be zoned away from the fights right now? Is RRQ. They're looking for more. Skylar, that win. Oh my god, Immortel will be back down, but Lord will be picked up by Albert. They're going to go for a comeback play, but it's not going to be good. R7 will lose his life. That is a very expensive Lord.
3 for the Lord. None gone on the side of Blacklist International. Shades of their finish. Shades of their last round in the MPL Invitational. Just two defenders. Lord coming out about 10 seconds. There's not enough time.
Let's see, man. The Lord is going to come in. It's going to be Oheb jumping in for the falling side. Went on to Albert, unable to kite away. It's going to be Blacklist keeping on going when the nature has been popped. But they're still managing to defend. What is this? RRQ! They're able to pop the immortalities, but only Clay left standing. Now, the mini waves are not for them. Clay in a 1v4. What can he do? Vin is going to spawn, but are they able to withstand once more without the help of the jungler, without the help of the high ground? It seems like it is, but it is inevitable. Clay's going to get engaged on Circle Eagle onto him, still able to kite around right now, as he's gonna be able to get some damage done, but Wise will pick it up. Vin now trying to clear away the minions. Numenon blasts all the way to the backside, still able to zone away the minions from that base. This is the defense of the King of Kings.
They're still in it. Edward using that Winter Truncheon, buying some time just like that. Blacklist International's call. Let's breathe, let's keep it in check. RRQ Hoshi, very well played. Not over just yet. Apparently, they didn't need time. They just needed the right decisions, the right calls, and they made it. 21 minutes in, they're still in this. R7.
Oh, look at the zoning from the Skylar! Look at him! He's going to be able to get Wise, but the guiding win! Matilda Airlines, bring him out. It's going to be Vin targeted. Edward, the ball going for the Hawks, trying to connect, but it's going to be him taken down. Skylar is looking for the picks. The 1v1 in the base. A 3v5 commences. RRQ still in the game.
RRQ showed up again. They played that draft very well. Skylar, he did his job going in for the Wise. But again, that was a beautiful display of how you should play with a Matilda. And this is why Matilda is so dangerous on the side of Blacklist International, because the entire team knows how to play with the guiding winds. And again, from the side of RRQ Hoshi, this is do or die as well, because even though it is the very first game, this sets the tempo for all games coming forward.
Yep. Gotta say, Skylar did great there. RRQ Hoshi did amazing on the defense, but we're still looking at Wise sitting at 808. It's gotta be a heartbreak for RRQ Hoshi to see this, and despite all their efforts, Yusen Shin not going down. The items, I think we're slowly coming up to the point where everyone will have everything they need.
Yeah, the thing is, everyone is looking very, very strong. It just becomes a situation where it is 22 minutes in the game. So whoever dies, then it's going to be a very, very tough decision on how they should engage this kind of team fights. Because on the side of RRQ Hoshi, they want to. But it's so difficult because they have very contradicting styles of playing, where from the side of R7 as well as Skylar, they want to go to the back, but the rest of their team, they want to kite. But right now, RRQ Hoshi, if they are able to get Wise, then Blacklist International, they're in trouble.
Look at the map right now. Blacklist and RRQ, they're setting up for something. Let's see, all right? Everyone stay quiet here. 5,000 gold lead on the board. Skylar will show himself up, and that's the Blacklist with the collapse. Right now, Skylar forced to run away. Certainly Eagle will be able to bring him all the way there. Oheb comes in, but it is the Flicker. Two ultimates being burned out. Actually, three. Edward, Wise, and Venus right now, but they are on very low cooldowns. Once again, RRQ will try to look for the cross-map play onto that bottom side.
Right now, I'm looking at Oh My Venus. The moment he has his ult back, RRQ Hoshi, they have to be careful because he's been targeting very well, either Vin or Albert. Because, all right, if he can't get Albert, he's just making sure that the Numinum Blast won't connect. And even that one is a very big ult use. And Blacklist International, they can definitely play around all of the cooldowns coming in from the side of RRQ Hoshi.
I agree. Vin is actually a bigger prize than Clay. And truth be told, Clay can actually play this very, very well. He can actually eat so many oats, force out all these green dots from Blacklist International, and then Vin can go for the counterplay. But at this point, RRQ Hoshi, I think the right play is to not give up anyone. Just make sure that you have the better engage, and I think their best chance at that is maybe at an overextended Lord take or maybe from within the base. But right now, they're doing very well at managing these waves. I'm impressed.
This Mountain Chakra is just so huge, man. Able to just basically nullify that flanking potential that Skylar has. And that's been the reason he hasn't been able to get any of these crazy pickoffs on the board here. As, again, it is going to be the Enhanced Lord started up by Blacklist International. Feather Airstrike to zone them away. Skylar once again proxying the wave and just being such a nuisance. But it is going to be the concealed popped away. Falling someone able to connect. Oh. Skylar actually not strictly Eagle though. Two resources being burned. If Skylar survived this, this is going to be huge. RRQ, they're already on the low. Edward is trying to zone away Albert right now, but RRQ will try to reset it. Blacklist will pick it up though. Let's see what happens. R7 pops the Black Dragon form, zoning away the members. Mountain Chakra will be able to reveal everyone on the map. The Lord is the target. Vin! He's gonna make it picked up. R7 jumps onto three members, able to get the Petrify and the Furious Dive on two, but will he be able to survive this? It's gonna be Edward falling on the backside. It's gonna be one of the immortalities, both of the immortalities, but a 2-for-1 for Blacklist. RRQ, they bit too much and they could chew. Blacklist will keep on going.
Yeah, right now, again, this is why I say RRQ Hoshi, they're having a difficult time during the team fights because all their members want to do different teams. From the side of R7 as well as Skylar, they want to go to the back, but the rest of their team want to kite. If we see the team fight just now, we can definitely see that Edward is chasing for Albert. But three of the members of the side of RRQ Hoshi, they're close to him. But whenever Skylar or R7 is targeting Wise, no one else is following them. So right now, two different personalities coming in from RRQ Hoshi.
Oh, Skylar's just buying time here. I think also one matter to note here is the heroes on the side of Blacklist International, their skills, their kits, they answer two or three from RRQ Hoshi, and right now they're in the base.
Oh my god, Circle Eagle all the way to the backside right now, able to connect onto Skylar. Immortality has been popped, but it buys a lot of time for the side of RRQ to defend. It's gonna be Lord taken down once more. The defense, what is this? RRQ, they're able to defend the Lord push, but now it is gonna be getting harder and harder for them. Blacklist, they're starting to get frustrated. A lot of HP has been taken down. They might look for the end, but no. RRQ, they survive one more time.
What a turn of events. Before this match, we said RRQ Hoshi should not let it drag out into the late game. They have to grow their patience. They have to evolve into a team that is just so used to being on the back foot. And so far,
oh my god, we're gonna pick off. It's gonna be him. Skylar picks off all over. Now, R7 in the midst of it all, trying to go for it, trying to survive. Circle Eagle will be able to connect all the way to the backside. Edward brought to the base. Albert is still alive. They have the high ground, but Blacklist don't have the setup. It is still RRQ in it.
As I was saying, they have evolved, but Skylar may have overextended. So far, still very impressive to see RRQ Hoshi, this kind of team, this aggressive, this technically offensive team, is just so good at this very long game. We're approaching 30 minutes.
Oh my god, Lekka Vin actually able to soak in so much damage and soak in so many ultimates. Blacklist, it is a 4v5, but they can't seem to crack the base open. Maybe with this wave. Let's see what happens. It's going to be Vin walking up to the front side. Mountain Shocker revealing everyone. Edward still trying to go in, but Venus, that is a little bit aggressive. Falling someone able to zone away Clay. Vin flickers out. Numinum Blast unable to connect to anyone, but it's going to be the re-engage coming from R7 to zone away the minions, and this game keeps on going. 27 minutes, baby! It's going to be R7 keep. Oh my god, what is going on?
Unstoppable force and unmovable object. Right now, Blacklist International, they have a lot of artillery. They have a lot of long-range skills able to poke out RRQ Hoshi. But again, having this Nathan as well as this Lilia, they can clear the minions very, very easily. And Blacklist International, they have to concede. They have to wait for RRQ Hoshi. They have to wait for Albert as well as Clay to die for them to really push for that victory.
First game of the best of five. Four Lords taken in this game. Three Turtles and all of RRQ's turrets. And it's still going.
I thought you were going to say a partridge in a pear tree, but this honestly is home court for Blackness International. A majority of their games from their home MPL have gone the distance. So playing into these multiple Lord matches, going into a half an hour game, it's really in Blacklist's wheelbarrow, but just the same. RKOshi, we did not expect for them to go this long, but looking at their lineup, This is what they want to do. So Albert sitting at 3-1-5, despite the deficit, despite being on their back foot for the longest time now, they still have a chance. It could honestly end in one single team fight.
And again, looking at Blacklist International, Y still has not died, and he has picked up his immortality as well, understanding that he is the main damage dealer coming in from the team. So from the side of RKOshi as well as Blacklist International, the Lord is going to be up soon. I'm confident that RKOshi, they can still protect or protect the base from a Lord push. Right now, I'm looking for an initiation, and I don't see it from RKOshi. I don't know what they can do right now.
Oh, look at that. For the airstrike, able to connect onto Albert and Clay. But you're talking about comfort here, and honestly, this is RQ's comfort as well. If you watch MPL ID, they've come back so many times. They've actually been named as the kings of comebacks right now. But look at how Blacklist are spinning up the map. They're going for an objective and also zoning it away. Look at Skylar, though. He's just been doing this constantly, being such a threat onto the side lane. And there you go. Top lane turret destroyed. The bottom side we control, and just like that, RRQ, they might have shifted the tempo. Look at how they're controlling the waves. Top side building up, mid lane pushed away, and the bottom side turret taken. Now it's gonna be Blacklist with the defense and RRQ on the offense.
That's one thing I was considering. Maybe RRQ Hoshi would love to trade these small Skylar objectives, and they bought so much time. And yes, again, Skylar demanding your attention. That's the kind of scary thing that this new player brings into this formula. If it was Zin, maybe he'd be more eager to join the team fights, win off of the traditional RRQ conversion. But right now, this new injection of talent and decision-making, it's keeping RRQ Hoshi in the game and actually keeping Blacklist International in check.
Oh, man, at this point, Blacklist were able to pick up that little wanderer, but LaFell, how do any of these teams end it?
Okay, so from the side of Blacklist International, this is going to be a pull and push coming in from both these teams. Blacklist International, they have to respect Skylar, because Skylar, he can push, but also look at his position. He can engage. Going in.
Yeah, R7 going to be able to get the Petrify onto Edward. Very good disengage with the Guiding Wind, but it is going to be RRQ controlling this part of the map right now. Blacklist, though, they don't want to give it up. They're going to go and open it up once more. Oheb using that Falling Star Moon wise with the Mountain Shocker. Those are two of the huge ultimates burnt out, but so did Albert and Finn. It's going to be an all-out fight here. I think it's going to be fight or flight. Man, RRQ still backing away. Clay needs to be careful. Black Shoes has been popped. This is huge for Blacklist. Let's see what they can do in this Lord fight. It just keeps on going.
Mind you, R7 still has the Black Dragon form, so they still have that huge potential for a turnaround despite having used his Petrify. Many times in M3, we've seen that tail whip from the Yuuzhong in half dragon form just win fights on its back.
Oh, man. How many times has the Lord been reset?
No, how many times had the feather, like,
yeah.
How many times has Haji used his ult right
now? How many skill rotations have we seen in just this moment alone? It's crazy.
Well, in before the Petrify comes off cooldown, 30 seconds.
Oh, Clay, once again, that's the second Black Shoes of this fight right now, as that's going to be the third Feather Airstrike popped out from Haji. Lord taking a half HP, RRQ are going to go for it. Wise, he's getting taken very low, and that might be the re-engage onto R7. Vin gets in on Numenas Blast onto the backside. Edward's going to get taken down, entropy being used. R7 versus everybody! He's still alive! He's going to be taken down, though. Immortality has been popped. Edward has been taken down. RRQ looking for the base. Look at the Lord right now, taking a half HP for the Airstrike, being able to zone on R7, but still able to run away for it now. Clay still kiting, and that is going to be the Lord. Wise, he's going to get chunked low. Oh, Skylar! What was that? He jumps in, and the turn after turn after turn. RRQ, they've done it, but Clay will fall in that fight.
Blacklist finally caught checkmate by RRQ Hoshi. Scores a great Lord there. It took a while, so much effort, but eventually, yes, Edward goes down. An amazing trade by RRQ Hoshi, and Skylar, again, could have sworn this young man was flying out the map. He was first seen recalling down bottom, pushing that lane, and the next thing you know, he's part of the fight.
And we also have to look at Albert. He's been micromanaging every single thing, because throughout that fight, he was handling Edward. He was guiding a lot of damage, and a re-engage R7 is looking for Wise.
Oh, Wise, he can't go anywhere. The stun comes in. Now to follow up. Albert, will he be able to connect? Why still able to dodge away? R7 dashes in with Fierce Dive, but it's only three members away. But it's going to be Albert hiding everybody. Look at this. R7 and Vin going on to Ohev. The stun is not ready just yet. It's going to be able to connect. And that's going to be Albert picking up the gun. Skylar! Look at Skylar! He's going in! Sneaking in! Inhibitor turret! Blacklist have cracked! That is one inhibitor taken. War, the King of Kings.
Skylar making like a Trojan horse. He's like, woo! All right, just chill, take the fight, I'm in.
What is this?
I'm in.
Right now, RK Hoshi, they are taking the textbook of team fighting and they're taking every single word by word and using it against Blacklist International, making sure, because again, I want to talk about Elbert. While he was fighting against Edward, he was still dealing damage onto Wise at the Lord. Destroyed. And right now, Albert again, 4-1 and 6, is surviving a lot of engages and he's still doing a lot of damage.
Oh my god, this might be the turn. Numenor Glass. No! Haji! Still able to run away, but a stun connects right there. It's going to be Blacklist now. On the defense, RRQ on the offense. The mini waves are building up. Vin gets a stun onto Edward, but Skylar unable to connect onto Jeet Kune Do. But look at Albert. Oh. No, that's not good for RRQ. He's gonna die. And RRQ, they're forced to back Blacklist with the defense. But they're gonna go in again once more. Now to back away from RRQ. Will they be able to do it? R7 is doing his best to zone to be able to peel for his team, but he's gonna get taken very, very low. Wise keeps on dashing in. Oh. They are looking for the kills. R7 goes in for Pierce Dive, able to get. But Skylar! No!
What
no
the?
Way! Skylar, he's gonna go to the base. He's gonna base waste. Look at the maps. What is going on? It's gonna be Skylar saving his team and isolating the members. But Vin, he's gonna get taken down here. And Blacklist picks it up. Clay goes in for Black Fuse.
Clay,
but I'll play. But a Wise goes in and takes it.
Skylar's the only one left. He did so much to carry this game. He's done so much threat in the base race, but he's still alive. 1v1 with his good friend Ohev.
Oh my god, Skylar is still alive right now. He's still trying to cut the waves. The Prince of the Skies has come to play. He is 1v4 right now, defending.
Look at how low that team fight was. When Albert died, he was on 80 seconds.
No.
Right now it's 20.
Bottom lane.
Oh no, Blacklist. They've tried their best. RRQ can't take it. Blacklist will be able to go to the first game. What a performance by both of these teams.
Very poetic. We ended this with a huge turnaround and that last moment before the final push down bottom. A close and intimate 1v1 between two good friends, Skylar and Ohev, both princes in their own kingdoms.
In case anyone was wondering why you guys thought RQ as well as Blacklist would go to the final, that was just
why.
The first game.
Exactly.
That was just the first game.
Exactly why.